It's national meets regional. Welcome to Sidewalks Entertainment, the long-running celebrity, music, and art series. Join us now for an exciting new path to celebrity interviews, music, rising talents, much, much more.
This is a really dumb idea.
Shh, Stubby. Shh, we can't let them hear you.
When they find him, they're gonna throw him overboard.
Who in the... What the devil is going on here? Better salute, sir. Someone's got a lot of explaining to do. Who smuggled this dog aboard?
He followed me on the train, sir. He was quite determined, but I swear I did not carry him on board, sir.
He sort of became the regiment's unofficial mascot, sir.
Based on a World War I true story, Sgt. Stubby, an American Hero, is a film about the first dog promoted to rank of sergeant in the U.S. Army, and till this day is the most decorated dog in American history. Here to talk about the film is Logan Lerman and Richard Lanni. Hi guys, how are you?
Hello.
Hi there.
Hey.
Hello.
Doing well, thank
you. Thanks again for joining me today. I'm really excited to have you guys on the show.
Oh, thank you for having us.
Thank you. Okay.
Now, Logan, some of us might not know this, and actually this was myself included. I had to revisit the films, but as a child, you started in films like What Women Want, The Patriot, Riding in Cars
Were
with
you in
Boys,
that?
And Butterfly Effect.
I was more of a, it's a glorified, extra in those films. I was a prop. I was the kid. Bring the kid in from school. He's doing school. Bring the kid. You sit here. You smile. You say a lie. You go back to school. But yeah, I did. I did work on films when I was that age. Yeah. So the first movies I worked on. Yeah.
Yeah, but you know what? Those were they were very unforgettable characters. I had to go back and be like, oh my gosh, that is him. Because your character in Butterfly Effect. Oh my God.
Yeah, that's intense.
Now, how did you get your first role at such a young age?
That's a good question. It's, it's hard to, think about the causality, like how you got here, or how you ended up where you are in life. But at that age, I'm from Los Angeles, so I think it was relatively easy to give it a shot. It was accessible to give it a shot to try to, audition for something, a project or something like that. So I think at a young age, I had some help, but just, went on a few auditions and got a few parts and then ended up on a movie. And then I ended up, the film that you talked about, The Patriot, I ended up doing that. And the actor who was the lead of that film, Mel Gibson, brought me onto that other film, What Women Want, afterwards, which actually helped me a lot, I think, in starting my career, because having two films that year at a young age, I think, helped get the next film, which then... it's like climbing a ladder step by step. I think it probably was a big reason for giving me momentum in the start of my career at a young age. But I was just a kid. I was just having fun. It wasn't really like work for me in a way.
Well, that's absolutely incredible. And plus, your first two films just happened to be with Mel Gibson in it. And that's just
amazing.
He
was very generous to me. He was very, very nice, very generous guy to me.
And now, Richard, from what I understand, before you became an award-winning documentarian and a historical filmmaker, you worked in business. What inspired you to make the career change?
Well, my brother was always the artist of the family, and he used to tease me. So one day I thought, I'm going to do what I want to do now. Mm-hmm. So I packed up in business, and I went to film school, and I started making documentaries, and that was at age 40. So I thought, I want to do what I want to do now. And I was really interested in history, and I wanted to find a way to make it more accessible to young people. And that's how it happened, really.
And now you've created the film based on the most incredible story about the most decorated dog in American history, Sgt. Stubby, an American Hero. By the way, I love the film. It's really great. I really liked it. Now, Logan, what led to you being casted as Robert Conroy?
You know, I had never done an animation before, and it seemed like a really fun opportunity, and it was presented to me with a story that I thought was worth telling. And I'm a dog lover. I love dogs. And I had no idea that this was a true story as well. It's a real dog, a real decorated soldier. And, the people involved attracted me. Helena Bonham Carter and Gerard Thibardeau were both involved already at the time. And, Richard, who's fantastic, and our composer, John Powell is
Patrick Doyle.
I'm so sorry, Richard Doyle. Oh, you got it. It's early in the morning, guys.
Yeah, we didn't get a lot of sleep last night.
My brain's not fully functioning yet. I still need to finish my coffee, but it was just a great group of people and a story that seemed like it was worth bringing to the screen. So.
And Richard, what was it about Logan that you felt made him such a good fit for this character?
Logan has a wonderful earnestness, which I felt our character had. You know, here were these young men, many of whom hadn't traveled, and they were being asked to cross the Atlantic to enter a conflict thousands of miles away. And I felt that we needed a character that had this kind of earnestness, and I mean this in the most respectful way, and a sort of naivety as well. I think that, I wanted that. So Logan was perfect. He was the right age. And he was absolutely perfect for the part for us.
And now this is your feature film debut. What was after you saw the finished product? Did the film come out the way you originally envisioned it?
You know, I'm now very happy with it. You know, when you first finish a project, you've been looking at it frame by frame for 2 years. You crawl all over it. You see all kinds of little things at the end. You go, oh, I've got to change this, got to change that. And then you have to sit back and take a breath because, you get to a point where you can't change anything. But, we're really happy with the movie now. At the time it finished, it was like you have a bit of PTSD, I think. And, and you want to, oh, God, I've got to go back and change this. But it's really all about the story and the way we've told the story. So, yeah, I'm happy with it now, very much. The team were amazing, and we worked with 250 wonderful artists in Canada who toiled around the clock to make this happen.
How's this dog get in here? Get out! Get out of here!
Hey, shh. Get off of me. Come on, go. I don't have any more food. Go eat. Shoot. Come on, you can get me in trouble. Get off. Go. Shoot, go, get away.
And what inspired you to tell the story of Sgt. Stubby in an animated film?
Well, we're dealing with war. It's a difficult subject matter, so I felt that we had much more control. If we wanted to make this accessible to young people, and we got our PG rating, we had much more control in animation. We could handle the violence, but it's off camera. We could really use our composer's music effectively to carry the emotion, and we could give the dog a personality because he doesn't speak. And we could really focus on him. So, tricks of the trade. We even gave him his own little key light. And in each scene, he's kind of slightly lit differently to the rest of the scene around him because he is the star of the show.
Mm-hmm. Now, from what I understand, it was kind of interesting how you came across the original story. From what I understand, did you randomly find out about the story just doing research on World War One, or
I was working on a World War One series, and I came across the story of the dog during that, and I just thought, oh my Lord, I have to do this. It has to be an animation. I really had no idea at the time what was involved in making a CG animated movie like this, but I just thought this has to be an animation, and we have to make it accessible for little kids and families generally.
Well, I can't wait to watch it again. This time with my son. So, it's a great story, and it was a wonderful film. Thank you so much.
Thank you, and I hope the audience really enjoy it. We're out tomorrow, and first signs are good. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you for having us.
Thank you.
Really quick, one last question before we wrap it up, Logan. I do have a fan question for you.
Okay. Yes.
Many of us are big fans of your character in the Percy Jackson films.
Yeah.
Now, if they continued in making a next film, how would you feel about coming back to play Percy Jackson?
Of course, I would love it. Yeah, I mean, I don't think. I mean, there's no plans to do that. But I feel like it's a few years too long to probably explore like another segment to that film. I think we're all getting a little bit older to reprise those roles. But no, I mean, I would love to. I mean, yeah, I really enjoyed that experience. That was really great.
Awesome. Well, again, wonderful work to the both of you. Sergeant Stubby and American Hero. Thanks again, guys.
Thank you. Bye.
Yep, good.
Thank you.
For more full-length celebrity interviews, visit SidewalksTV.com.